Hi folks, I'm Adam, and today we're looking at a super easy way to make ghost blocks using the new clone command from the 14 week 3 snapshots. If you don't know what ghost or phantom blocks are, the idea is pretty straightforward. These are client-side only blocks that look like normal blocks, but if you right-click on them, even in adventure mode, they disappear. So, they make for a cool little trick in adventure maps, or even just as a great way to toy with your mates. Now, I've done a few videos on ghost blocks in the past, but never has it been so easy to produce one. The clone command in the latest snapshots is a really powerful one that allows you to carbon copy a portion of the map to a different location. However, due to what I presume is a glitch with the clone command, attempting to overwrite a block that has a tile entity with an air block produces a phantom block. Tile entities, for those of you that, you know, play Minecraft for the fun elements, they're bits of additional data that allow certain blocks to store more information than they normally would. For instance, the items in a chest, or maybe a mob in a monster spawner. You can see here all of the different blocks that you can turn into ghost blocks using this trick, as they all contain tile entities. If we click this button to trigger a clone command, we can even test this theory out. Oh, there's something actually rather cathartic about doing this. So, let's take a look at the commands we've used here. It's actually all nice and easy, I've covered the main areas behind it already. Firstly, this section of repeaters here is just to replace the floor with lava when I push the wooden button that was behind this block. This was done with another new command, the fill command, and then 5 seconds later I switch it back to polished granite. The ghost block itself is formed just using this section here. Now to start off, there is no ghost block, there isn't even an actual furnace. As we walk into the doorway, the command block attached to a clock detects us and then powers the rest. The first command block replaces the wooden button with a stone block, and this is done so that when we use the second command block to place the furnace, it faces in the direction we want it to. After the repeater, we then turn the stone back into a wooden button, and finally we issue the clone command. The clone command is only for a single block, in fact it's for the block directly above the furnace, and then we clone that block, which is an air block, onto the furnace. As it's an air block, it triggers the glitch, and the furnace is converted to a ghostly furnace. However, as you saw, removing these ghost blocks is as easy as just clicking on them, but you can also get rid of them by dying or re-logging. Fortunately, resetting a setup like this is as simple as re-entering the room, which will trigger the test for command again and reset the trick. Well, that's all for this time. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.